Thank you. Thank you. Well, your father says so, and your father knows best.
Yes, it's Father Knows Best, transcribed in Hollywood, starring Robert Young as Father. A half-hour visit with your neighbors, the Andersons. Brought to you by America's favorite coffee.
Well, I'll come here.
The coffee that's always good.
Ha 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 ha
Betty, I think that's a very selfish attitude. After all your father has done for you. Kathy, we're going to devote the entire day to your father.
I know, but Betty said I didn't have any place else to go, and I do, because I can go over to Betty's and play, or I can go over to everybody else buys their father an entire sock. Why do we have to be different?
Because your father is one of the sweetest men in the entire world.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. All right, hey. I'm the developer of the game. I've never done anything like this before, but I thought it'd be cool to just hide this in the game here. I'm just going to be poking around the files. So I haven't finished the game yet as of recording this. As you can see, I only have a few of the ending videos down here, but yeah, I don't know. I just thought I'd do some behind the scenes. So this is the title screen here. Not much to look at. So let's go over to the plant room. Poke around here. Yeah, so this was before I found out that Modus actually made some shaders for the caustics on the walls. So they're actually a separate model here. Let's see. Yeah, look at that. Of course, we have our friend back here. There he is. As you can see, I didn't know what to call him, so I just called him Guy. Plant Room Guy. And actually, let's see if I can find this. Let's see if it's still in here. Yeah, okay. So I cut this out of the room because I thought it didn't really match the scenery very well, but there's a fountain. I put a fountain in the game. We can take a little look at it in game, of course. Look at that. It does look pretty nice. Maybe I'll use it in something someday. I don't know. Alright, let's go ahead and move on to over here, but it does not look like a raccoon very much. I originally tried to texture his head with like realistic raccoon fur and everything, and it did not work out at all. Not even a little bit. And early in play testing, actually, I found out that you could just walk up the walls and just fall down into the pit down here. And I thought, you know what? I'll just hide something down there. I'm not even gonna get rid of that. Yep. And I placed this area up here behind the two bushes because I just really wanted to have a nice little secret in this first starting area. It's kind of inspired by the there's a caves in Lego Island. There's like a door that's inaccessible. That's just really mysterious, and I love little alcoves and little holes and stuff like that. So that's why that's there. All right. This is one of the later ones I made. The well actually used to be placed over here, and you could only access it by getting up on the plant, getting up here, and then jumping down into it. But I thought, you know, I kind of want it to be accessible really early on so that you wouldn't have to jump through a bunch of hoops just to get there. So here it is. It's right here. I experimented with having more light shafts, but I felt it was a bit too much, so Just kept it like that. Yep. Oh, the gravestone here. The text there. It's actually... It says a few things. It says Lorem Ipsum. And then it says... I believe L is real, 2401, as a reference to some rumors surrounding a certain Nintendo 64 game. And I forgot what the last bit says, but yeah. So I just put some filler text there. This kanji here actually translates to birch. And in the Nightmare Zone, it's different. You see, that means, I believe, to have a nightmare. And this area, the graphical, I guess, intensity of it or whatever, kind of came about by accident. I didn't intend to even have this area in the game at first. I didn't plan for it, but, I accidentally dragged the render texture material onto the walls inside of Cherry Blossom, and I just thought it looked neat, so I decided to make a whole area based around that. Over here... Oh, shoot. Here, let's... Over here, I thought it'd be cool to hide a character based on the... vertex snapping of it being like so intense that the further you get away from it, it just basically becomes invisible. But this closer you get, there he is. He's really unstable. This character doesn't really have a lot to do in the game, but you know, I just thought it'd be cool to hide him there. Add a bit of flavor, if you will. This is a really cool place to develop the only high poly asset in here, in the whole game right here. The soup cans. I really don't know why I chose soup cans, but yeah, there they are. Of course, this is a picture of me that I just used for the scientist. Yep. And on this board here, we actually have some stock photos that were on the title screen, actually, like over here and here. This right here is the painting that is hung up in the Cherry Blossom area. That's the Unity logo, of course. This is the letter that you receive, or that you just have in your inventory at the start of the game. This is, of course, the eyeball symbol that relates to the plant room and the churches and all that. This right here is a picture of the body stuck in the wall that's in the suburbia area, which you might as well check out. Or not the suburbia, the house area. Yeah, here we are. So originally I was gonna have the mom's face scroll between a few different arrangements like this, kind of inspired by the Land of the Living in Grim Fandango, but I don't know, I just accidentally had it scrolling in two directions, and that just scrolls through her whole texture there. Like, you can see the hair texture and the faces show up, and I don't know, that looked a bit more chaotic, and I decided to keep it. Hopefully people will see that and think it's unintentional. But yeah, there's the image that was on the cork board, the conspiracy board, if you will. All right, now let's check out suburbia. So this area is a bit interesting because I wanted to give off the vibe that it goes on forever, but it's actually very small, and it just teleports you as you're walking through it. So right here is the player's position, as you can see, and here, let's set this up so that we can see all of it. Turn off the fog. Okay. Yeah, so right there is the player's position. Right there is the player's position. And as we walk, we hit a trigger that teleports us back. And this works in either direction. And as you keep going, eventually it'll detect that you've walked enough to let you go on into the lab. Might as well take a little peep. We got a gazebo, the ocean, which maybe doesn't go out as far as you might think. Yep. The sand texture down there is a little messy. You know, you can see the seams of it, but you know, you can get away with that sort of thing. Got the submarine here. Alright. Ocean floor. Let's look at this one. Let's turn off the fog again. Turn up the cutout distance. Why not? Look at that. That's the whole area. You got the walls stretch out about that much. There you go. Hope somebody's interested in that. Well, yeah, I hope you enjoyed this stupid little behind the scenes, me messing around little video that I hid in the game. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe you got something out of it, maybe you didn't. I don't know. I just thought it'd be a fun little thing to do, I guess. Anyway, yeah, I hope you have a good day. Hope you enjoyed the game. If you didn't, that's alright. Yeah. I don't know what else to say. So, bye.